this summer I went on a trip to Alaska.
Yeah, so it was a 47-day trip that I had been leading up to, and I went with six other wonderful women, and we paddled down the Shinjuk River in Alaska. So I have been canoeing since I was in fifth or sixth grade, and we started with a small week-long trip in the Boundary Waters and worked our way further north and longer times away. And our capstone trip was supposed to be in Canada, but actually because of COVID, we ended up having to go to Alaska. And I was afforded the wonderful opportunity because of this to go backpacking, because the rivers in Alaska aren't long enough to support a 47-day trip, that we actually did a 10-day backpacking loop before heading down the Shinjuk River. And this was my first time ever backpacking, and it was incredible. Ooh, about 1 week into our backpacking trip, it had been raining for three straight days, and a lot of us were not feeling very well, but at lunchtime, it had completely cleared up, and we had decided to backpack up a mountain. We walked through the clouds, and when we got to the top, we could see all the way down the river valley. We could see the whole Shinjuk, which was crazy, because it was like, as canoers, we were really excited to paddle this beautiful water, and we could see all the way down to where we were headed for the next 40 days. Our first day, actually, on the water was the roughest, with it being very braided water. You couldn't tell what was coming up and it was rushing. My friend Mel and Noah were paddling the canoe and went around a corner, got into a huge wave, got caught up against a tree and were pressed between the canoe and the tree themselves, and luckily were able to like pull themselves out. All of our canoe and our gear and everything went floating down the river, and we were whistling and running through the water to try to catch all of our things. We ended up losing two packages that we ended up finding the next day. We ended up losing our dinner pack and Macy's gear pack, but we had plenty of enough clothes to go around, and early on in our trip still had food. Luckily, we were able to find all of our gear, but that was probably the closest to danger that we had encountered on our trip. It's a feeling that's kind of hard to explain to someone who hasn't been on such a adventure. The day when we got off the river, we had just undone our canoes and put them back into bags, which is a crazy feeling on its own, but we sat in a circle and read this passage. I don't remember who it was by, but it was loosely talking about we have to give grace to the people that are welcoming us back, because we have bonded so closely that it's almost like we don't want anyone to encroach on our little bubble. And we have to give grace to them because they're expecting the same person to come back, and we're not going to be coming back as the same person. Yes, obviously the trip changed me in many ways. A huge thing that I noticed on the trip was taking into account perspective. Some of the girls on my trip were not people that I would normally have been able to become really good friends with. The way I view it is you can speak to someone for every single hour of every single day, and what they tell you is all that you can do to try to get to see their perspective. And even if you talk to them every single day of your life, think marriage, think best friend, these women that I went and lived with for so long, I think you can only really even get like 10% of their perspective from what they're telling you. And so trying to like gain as much of that as you can was really something that I was really interested in seeing how that played out when I got back home. In addition, I learned a lot from being close to nature while being gone, and just being part of almost a sense of being held. The river was almost like a mother figure to us. She was keeping us safe, she was carrying us along. Occasionally we would do things, and obviously nature is gonna fight back. We're ultimately powerless against nature, and that sense of just taking what's coming brings a lot of sense of stillness to like your soul. And taking that back with me, I've found that I can find that within community as well as nature. The sense of being held, not necessarily powerless, but you can find that so long as you have each other, you can find the stillness inside of you and be able to take whatever is coming your way.